The Azure Tips and Tricks series is the easiest way to stay as productive as possible in Azure. With nearly 200 tips and tricks so far, even Azure experts can learn something new. Michael Crump is here to give us a tour of the Tips and Tricks universe today on Azure Friday. Hey everyone, Donovan Brown here with another episode of Azure Friday. I'm here with Michael and we're going to learn about Azure Tips and Tricks. Now, I found your tips and tricks recently. Tell me about the origin and how that actually started happening.
Sure. So Azure Tips and Tricks, it primarily started with when I was working with Azure and I come across different things that I felt that I needed to document.
Gotcha.
So I may find something in Azure App Service and I was like, oh, okay, well, what if I actually started collecting all these tips? Because sometimes I don't have that great of a memory. And I could document it not only for myself, but I could document it from the community. What has happened since then is that Tips and Tricks series has grown until about 192 as
wow.
of this time. And also 40 plus videos that have had like 700,000 views
nice.
On the official Azure YouTube channel to a couple of books.
Wow.
Two books. And even conference talks. Like I did some stuff at Build and Ignite and even some of the other third party type of conferences.
That's fantastic to take something that you did just to make sure that you would remember how cool this stuff is and then be able to have it reach so many different people and so many different platforms. I mean, to have ebooks, to have video series, to have the blog post, which is what I found. I forget what I was searching for, but it's like, yeah, I know Michael. Like, holy crap, this is like a lot of good stuff. And I started tweeting it out and it's just kind of neat to see how that stuff works. So is this just you doing this or can other people get involved and where can they go and find that information?
Yeah, so it's actually not just me.
Okay.
So it originally started with just myself, but since then with some of the written blog posts, I've brought in a couple of MVPs that helped
Very
me out.
Cool.
Not only just like MVPs, but some of our CDAs, such as Cecil Phillips, who has done quite a bit of amazing work for me, and especially in the video space.
Nice.
So I've been, the content that I've been producing, I've been making sure that there's others that's out there that may know a certain section of the universe a lot better than I do.
Got it.
And then I can accept their pull request because it is an open source project.
Cool, so where do I go to start like listing and searching and viewing all these tips and tricks?
Yeah, so you actually go to azuredev.tips.
Azuredev.tips.
And I made it really, really easy. It's actually hosted on GitHub and it's a GitHub page. So what's obviously nice about that is that we're able to, I'm able to accept the pull request. And if folks have different types of questions, they can go into the issue tracker, select a question. I've already pre-filled out the template.
Gotcha.
Where I'm exactly what I'm trying to look for or how I can help them. One other nice aspect to that is that by open sourcing all of the tips, is that now I can allow people like our program managers inside of Microsoft to help out and say, oh, okay, hey, Crump, you missed something here. Let me help you out. Or even just the developer community can go in and take a look and help me make sure that if I have, you know, a problem with the services or maybe there's something that's not broken, they can help me out. And what's really great about this is that I hate to admit this, but I broke the build myself. I know, not very smart. And it did not take but really a couple of minutes before a member of the community was like, hey, Crump, like go over here. You did something wrong. So,
gotcha.
Yeah.
So show me the website so I can see how, because I have 190 some odd tips and tricks. It has to be interesting to be able to navigate through that.
Yeah, absolutely. So this is the site. I've made it intentionally very clean and to the point. A lot of the times folks, they don't like to load like a whole bunch of graphics and animations. So with this site, it's super lightweight. The only time you'll see an image is actually in the actual tip.
Okay.
So inside of this, you know, obviously we've got things like search functionality. So if you're looking for something like with Azure Logic Apps, which is one of my near and dear services that we provide, because I use it for a lot, you can obviously just, you know, type that in, you know, hit a button, and even here's a program manager, Stefan Wick, who had helped me out with making sure that this was a very good, solid blog post. Not only can you do, you know, those sorts of things, but while you're inside of this, if you want to get these quick links over to like videos, I found some folks, they really like just videos.
Sure.
And they can navigate with this button over to the Azure playlist. So we've created a huge playlist. It's kind of like the Netflix style, where we put one video, and next video, the next video. And I found that most people, once they start watching the videos, they will continue. And again, that those videos are completely based off of the blog post.
Got it.
So if you've seen it in a blog post and you don't prefer to like read,
understood. Sometimes
you can go video.
Got it. And this is just a YouTube playlist that people can then go and use, right?
Yeah. Absolutely. And anyway, I'll just bring this up super quick. While that's and you can kind of see this is some of the the videos that we have.
Gotcha.
Outside of that, obviously there's the ebooks and some, where you can add questions. The RSS feed was one of the first things folks were asking me. Hey, I want an RSS feed to keep up with the latest and greatest. I didn't know if RSS was still like a big thing, but apparently it is. And then from the previous site that I had, and I'm too embarrassed to actually show that right now, but the previous site that I had, you had to really go to like a master page and you had to like look for the category that you were interested in and then select, but you had to go through a lot of different tips, like every tip was listed. And I've tried to make that a lot easier by breaking it out into, oh, okay, if you don't want to use this search and maybe you know, the current thing that your boss has you working on is like authentication, you can click on authentication, you can read every single post that's been created so far.
Gotcha. Very cool. And show me again, so I know this is actually being run out of GitHub, but this is also where if I wanted to contribute a tip or a trick, I would come here as well, right?
Exactly. So one thing you'll notice, so this is the actual repo. This repo was created about a month and a half ago is when I went live on this side of it. But on each one of the pages, the absolute best way that you can contribute is go to a page, and at the bottom, there is this edit this page on GitHub. And so you'll see here, it brought it up. You can edit the file. Obviously, you know, you'll make I have like a Git workflow of what you'd want to do. But you can edit the file, and then you can submit that to me. I'll make sure, full request. I'll take a look, and then if everything is great and golden, then I will give you some credit up at the very top.
Awesome. Well, this is really, really cool stuff. Yeah, like I said, I forget what I was searching for that day, but I started, just like you said, I read one of them and I just kept reading and kept reading because there's such bite size, right? There's not like you're reading this big, long, arduous documentation. You're like, wow, that's awesome. And then you go and try it and you come back like, that's awesome. And you just keep going back and forth, which is really cool.
And I learned that completely through like my own like patterns of like web browsing, like medium.com.
Gotcha.
Kind of has the 2 minutes to read.
Sure.
And I found that with myself, I look for 2 to 3 minutes to read before I'll
get bored and want
get bored and want to go to something else. Hey, there's always like a YouTube screaming in the background.
Sure, exactly. Like,
hey, there's a funny cat video. Go check it
watching.
Out.
Exactly. Well, Michael, this is awesome. I really, like I said, it's really cool to have this show because I've benefited from these tips and tricks, and I hope other people do as well. So we're learning all about Azure tips and tricks here on Azure Friday.